What is going on? Peeps here again for another exciting Star Citizen look at. We're looking at some larger size ships. So I think the 3-4s, the ones that are now able to load inside the Revel in New York. My bigger ships cannot load in here, and they're not available to see yet. So can't really show you. But we'll be able to see those things. Guys, like we see, give a thumbs up. Throw in some comments. We'll answer as much as we can. And then also go ahead and subscribe. We'll see more of the sheets spread around. As we showed before, you can fit 3 1-2 size ships, and when it comes to 3-4s, you can fit 2 3s and 1 4. So size 3 is right here. As you see, we have a Freelancer, which will pop up one of those. I have 2 Freelancers, so we'll pop up one of the Freelancers, and then the other one we will pop up. Where's the other 3? Here. The other 3 will pop up that bad boy. I see that thing hop when I select the Freelancer. So this is a Freelancer. Or I see it hop when I selected the Warden. Freelancer is, I think, the best all-around, you know, ship for the money you can get. There's 4 variants. It comes with pretty darn good weapons. I think they're size 4 cannons. Okay, so these are size 3, but there's 4 of them. 2 here, and then there's the Warden. 2 here. So you can see you get a dramatic amount more when it comes to larger weapons. You also have a lot of missiles, which is awesome, you know, to get yourself away. So size 4s, size 3s, you can outfit it with size 2s, size 1s, multiples. It's pretty darn cool. It has a awesome amount of cargo space, so you can actually haul a lot of things. Plus, up on top is another set of, you know, cannons. So it's pretty darn good. I mean, right up there. So it's got another set. So you can actually, this thing can fly 5 people. So you can have a rear gunner, lots of cargo space. It's, you know, just freaking awesome. Until I kind of just tell people, you know, if you're going to start this game, save up some money. You get the Aurora just so you can start flying around, look at this stuff. Save up some money, get the Freelancer. This is just the thing you want to do. Freelancers basically start at, I think, 110 and go to 150, depending on what size you get. This is the standard one, and again, for the money, it's the most rounded ship you can get. The other versions are like Explorer, Policing, Cargo, so it's just amazing. So there's 2 cargo bays, one here, and there is cargo in here. And one time I logged in, there was guns in here. So, yeah, there's a piece of cargo inside here. So you've got 2 cargo bays. One holds a larger amount. You can also fit your 2 ships inside here. So it's awesome. So, like, your dragonflies, the Noxes can go inside here. And some of the buggies. I do have a bunch of ground vehicles. so some of them will actually fit inside here, which is kind of cool. Yeah, cargo. Didn't know there was going to be cargo in here. So, you go into the front of the aircraft. So basically, this is the front. So you have a ladder and escape door here. So you can actually come in through the side, or you can come in through the back. Crew of 4 beds. And then you go into here, so you have navigators, co-pilot, and pilot. And this is more like a, you know, you're driving, you know, a bus. Power on. Boom. So you can see all the different screens. Again, just like any other ship, you can actually program these screens. Open all exterior, pop up HUD. I mean, you've got full access to it. So Copilot there. Yeah, it's just, it's pretty awesome. And that is the Warden. I might make this guy go away just so you can see the Warden. But you see shields right here. No targets. I mean, it's just really, really cool. Power it off. Let's exit. Again. Pilot, co-pilot, navigators. It's just awesome. Again, this is like the all-around, you know, thing to get. There's an airlock up there, so in case the ship has crashed out, yeah, get out. And then over here is your rear gunner. So you can actually enter the turret if you want to. But that is the Freelancer. Because of the amount of ships I have, I'm part of the concierge service. So, yeah. Alright. Take away the Freelancer, and now we have the Warden. This is a heavy fighter. It's probably one of the most badass ships that are out there. Crazy with firepower. And yeah, it's just insane. Just what this thing can do is just madness. Yeah. So you have size 4 weapons. Like how it has, anyone who's in the military knows the Punishers. Yeah, kind of reminds me of that. Apocalypse Arms, just that right there reminds me of a group. When I was in the Marines, there's a group that uses that, who are Navy SEALs and stuff like that, so it's pretty badass. So, you have 4 Type 2, 1 massive Gatling gun, Type 2 rockets, Type 3 rockets, more Type 4 rockets, Type 3s. That's another pylon there. Yeah, this thing can be loaded down. I mean, just loaded down. So, yeah. And I think stuff can go... Yeah. So, there you go. More ordnance, more ordnance. Yeah, this thing can really hold its own. Alright, so let's go ahead and... Okay, so the Warden is entered through the back. I always screw this thing up because it's difficult for me. Something special. It never... No, got it the first time. Okay, so the Warden not only is, you know, a crazy fighter, but you can... Oh, it does this every... This thing right here still is crazy. So that thing blocks you, but... What is with the fires? So you still see there's some clipping. This thing right here is blocking, you know, the doorway, so it's gotta be fixed. Ramp. Everything's on fire at mine. So basically you have a small kitchenette, there is beds here. So 1, 2. There is a bathroom here, gun racks, engineer station. So that's pretty cool. Get out of this thing. Oh, wait, hold on. You see, I've never engineered it before, so. Oh, I didn't do anything. There's the bathroom. Alright, so go into here. You can store small things of cargo around this thing. Again, weapons, racks, and things like that. So you can actually get a little bit of cargo. Is it recommended? Don't really know. There's my light. So. But you can get a little bit of cargo in here, so you can actually run a little bit of stuff with this thing. Don't know how well, but you can run some stuff. So, enter the pilot seat. Now. This kind of... I mean, it kind of... It's not really like a flight stick I've seen on an actual aircraft. There's a little bit too much, you know, button-wise and stuff like that. But on some of the aircraft I've seen in the game, the flight sticks look just like the Warthog. So. Engine on. Power on. Again, like every other aircraft, you can actually adjust all this stuff right here. So. This is where a radio would be. Ejection. But yeah, this is the Warden, one of the really badass ships. Right, let's get in the seat. I left it on. Let's get out of the fire. Why is everything freaking on fire? So, that is the Warden. And then we're gonna go to one of the big boys. So, with the bigger ships, you can only put one of them inside of these bays. So you have to go to the middle. Basically size fours. And you'll see size four, one, two. Click on size four. There's the Andromeda. You run this way. And there's the Connie. I can't say this is the best ship for the value, just because it is very expensive. 200 plus. But it is ridiculously armed. Well, that's interesting. Not quite sure what that is about. But where's the thing? Let's respawn it. Because I can't get into it. With it flipped like that. Okay. Here's the county. What is this thing doing? So, here's... I'm afraid to get near it. It's going to kill me. One size 4 cannon. There'll be another size 4 cannon over here. One other size 4 cannon up there, and on the other side another size 4 cannon, and then there's two turrets up top. Okay, what is with this thing? So from here, if it was acting normal, what are you doing? There we go. I just saw it somewhere. There it is. Boom. Okay. There's the cargo bay door. And then there is the elevator. So there's two ways to get on this ship. Cargo bay. Elevator. So sometimes you can get yourself crushed inside here. So you gotta watch out. Alright. Start at the back. Don't pay attention to the missiles. We'll get to those. So, in the back of the Connie, there is your X-58. So there's your snub fighter. So in case all, you know, in case this place breaks up or anything like that, you run over to the back and get into your snub. This bad boy has a lot of storage. So, come back through here. This is main room, so basically you've got a lot of places to actually store things. Cargo bay. That's one spot. Right here. So even though this thing's got a big cargo bay, you can actually put the rovers inside here, other, you know, aircraft, whatnot. Park them all inside here. But what's awesome, this thing holds 24 missiles. And these are like no joke ones. So they're pretty freaking cool. And they're size 5s. Freaking awesome. Very high powered. Coming into the sleeping quarters, you know, you've got a crew for sleeping, storage lockers, and some of the lockers open. As you can see, you can actually store uniforms and stuff inside these. This is the bathroom. You see a shower. There is a table to eat at. This is the elevator we came up on. Sleeping beds. Yeah, this is an airlock. So we have lower turret, upper turret. This thing is armed. So you can have two friends in turrets, avionic systems, which my guess at one point in time will be available. You'll be able to use all this stuff, shield gen, things like that. And then you've got the pilot, co-pilot, and navigator. So. So, let's go ahead and go in the pilot seat. So controls are just like anything else. You can open all the exterior, unlock it. Screens. There we go. Engine on. There is. Power on. There we go. Boom. Okay. There's your screens. You can set these things all up too, just like you do before. So you're able to actually, you know, scroll through different screens. There's your lasers, cannons, shielding, you know. So again, you're able to do, you know, a lot of modification to this stuff here. Flying and everything like that. It's pretty easy. You do all the modification also to these screens here. So it's actually pretty cool. Yeah, this thing's armed to the teeth. Lots of stuff. Exit, come on. There we go. So this is not the biggest ship that I own. I own an even bigger one. But it is not rendered and ready for use yet. So, it kind of sucks. So. And that is the Connie. The bigger ship that I own, I don't think will fit in here. It's like 2 or 3 times the size of the Andromeda. So, not sure how you're going to see that one yet. I also have a bunch of ground vehicles. Usually when I launch them inside here, they turn upside down. So I'll just kind of come over here. I can only show 2 or 3 of the ground vehicles that I have. There's the Ursa. Boom. So this is the Ursa rover. Entrance door. There's also this back door. Again, there's a cargo piece in the middle. Jump seats. Cannon. Let me throw down the other one. Here's the gray cat. So there you can see the actual back of the snub. The X-58 right there. So basically you jump inside of it and just drops down. So the Ursa. Getting this thing is always weird. It likes you to be down like this. The door is not opening. Oh, there it goes. So, there you go. You have the pilot and co-pilot. And, you know, you do everything else you do with these things, so... Power on. Welcome to Robert Space Industries. Engine on. So I close the exit. There's like, I haven't really driven this thing, so forget how you do anything with it. You can't read shit. But you see there's the way the Ursa is all set up. And the gray cat's the only one I did drive. So let's see the show. Pretty much when I had this thing first time, I drove it like a few like meters and the thing flipped over. So yeah, still not quite working yet. Basically, this guy's like a little dune buggy. Guy's just a little dune buggy and look around. Yeah. That's it. I mean, so that's all the ships that I can actually show at this time. The rest of them have been removed to show, and my other stuff, it's just, I don't think it's going to show until 3.1 is my guess. Other than that, that's it. So you guys, like we see, go ahead and hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you want, throw some questions in there. Let's get the sheet rolling. Peace.